Welcome, my name is Jennifer Paz. In this video tutorial, I'll show you how to create both a Perusall text-based assignment and its associated Canvas assignment. In the process, I'll note some key tips and tricks that I've learned through trial and error. I've already got my Perusall tab open. I got to it from Canvas from within the course that I want to add the assignment to, obviously. But it's important to note that I already have Perusall installed in my Canvas course. Installing it required me to go to settings and add it, but in some cases you have to get a code from your university to add it, so check on that, and once you've got it installed, you're ready to go. Just clicking on that Perusall tab will load it in another tab. You do have to set up your Perusall course as well, but it's not too difficult. And once you get it set up, you can start adding assignments. I have a number of documents already added here, but you aren't limited to just adding a textbook or other text-based items anymore. Now you can even add a video, as you can see. My students are international students learning English, and right now we're studying our TED Talks textbook that was not available as an ebook, so I made an assignment based on the downloadable transcripts that Cengage provides. I've already uploaded the PDF here just to save time, even though with a short document, it's very quick to process. If it's a longer PDF or ebook, it may take a while, but you don't have to sit and watch it. You can just come back when it's done. To make an assignment is very easy. You can go right here to click on Assign, and it will ask you to verify that you chose the correct document. Then, if you don't want to assign all of the pages for one particular assignment, you can just assign a page number or range, and you can even skip around as well. But if you just want all of it, you don't have to do anything. You can even use the same document multiple times if you want to assign 10 pages one night and another 10 pages another night, for example. Next, you will give the assignment a due date for submissions. In this case, the program is remembering the last due date I set, but sometimes the date will be blank when you first start. If you needed to change it, you could just click around here and change it. Now I will type the new assignment name, and I will also make sure to tell my students that it's a Perusall assignment, just to be clear. I also want to mention to my students that it's a required assignment because I have set some as optional. For practice usually. As for the settings to grade their annotations, that's up to you. You can increase that amount or you can lower it. Unfortunately, you cannot use an external tool like this without making it a type of graded assignment. That's why I just mark it complete or incomplete if I make it optional. Obviously, it's up to you how you want to deal with the grading, but you can also override any grade before reporting it to Canvas, and you don't even have to send it to Canvas. You can just enter a grade in Canvas yourself. Okay, so the next step is to say when you want the assignment to begin. I would like them to begin tomorrow at 2 when my class starts. You can also assign it to specific students, but that's not usually what you're going to do. And you can make it anonymous or optional. Now, what's great about Perusall is that you will see their overall progress, even their average reading time. And it's really nice to be able to go into the comments and see where they were confused and what they were saying about the text. As a language teacher, that's extremely helpful to me to see if they've misunderstood a part or asked a question about it, since they often won't ask in class. I won't get too much into the benefits here, but you can see analytics and download all sorts of data here, and you can also edit your assignment anytime. Now, what you want to do right now as you're setting up the assignment in Perusall is to copy the full title to use in Canvas. This is really important if you want the assignment to be correctly linked to Canvas. So I've copied that, and now I'm going to go over to Canvas and I'm going to create a new assignment in the appropriate section. Once I set up an assignment, I'm going to paste that exact title into the Canvas assignment name. If you don't have the exact title, I promise that it will not connect to Perusall properly, meaning it won't load the right assignment, although it will take them to Perusall. It also won't send the grade back if you wanted to use that method. Now, I've done these kinds of assignments before, so I'm just going to copy a previous assignment as a template. So this one is like that, and it just takes a second to copy. On a side note, if you don't know how to use these awesome design tools, I do recommend learning. They will save you lots of time and they will make your assignments more transparent. There are lots of easy tutorials if you search out Canvas design tools. Now this was for the previous unit, so I'm going to paste my title that I have here. I also had a short perusal tutorial introduction here that I just leave at the top there to remind students how it works. I have occasionally done a 0 point or optional assignment just to practice because, as I noted previously, you can't make it ungraded in Canvas if you want to link it to Perusall. So you have to either make it a 0 point assignment or mark it as not counting towards the final grade. However, this assignment will be 10 points. I also found a YouTube video from another university that I use to help them understand how to actually make the annotations. I should probably make my own someday, but I haven't had time yet and this one serves the purpose. I just need to make some minor edits to revise the details here. And yes, I often repeat the same instructions in multiple places because my students often miss the key information if I don't. Okay, so again, I need to indicate how many points the assignment should be in Canvas, and then I have to come down here and choose External Tool. Once you find Perusall on the alphabetical list, I recommend clicking the option to have it load in a new tab. When choosing your due dates, you'd probably want to make those due dates the same as the ones you put on Perusall. However, I have occasionally scheduled them so that they are different on purpose. It depends on your assignment design. For example, sometimes I have a due date on Canvas that is sooner than the one in Perusall because I might simply want students to get it done by a certain date, but still have access to the document and annotations in Perusall in case they need to go back and use the text to study for a test or prepare an essay or a presentation, for example. However, I want them to complete their reading and discussion long in advance of any test or major assignment. So in this case, our test is at 2 p.m. on July 20th, so by then, they won't likely need this document again. They could, however, download it. I'm now finished with this assignment, and notice that if I scroll to the bottom, it says load this assignment, and I want to show you what happens. First, I'm going to close my Perusall tab so you see that if I click on that link, it should take me directly to the exact document and assignment. All right, so there it opened up the assignment and it's already ready to go and they can start making highlights called conversations. Basically, they just highlight a section of the text or even a graphic and then type a comment. That's what Perusall calls a conversation, not an annotation, by the way. Obviously, it is what we think of as an annotation, but they call it a conversation because students can come over here and upvote the ones they like. I'm not going to show you all the cool things possible, but I wanted to warn you that if your students go in and just make notes on an assignment, the other students cannot see those notes, and it takes a great deal of effort for the instructor to find them because they are intended to be private. Therefore, Perusall also does not grade their private notes. So make sure that your students are adding conversations instead. And that is the end of this tutorial on how to set up an assignment in Canvas to use Perusall. I hope you found it helpful.